G'day, legends. We're back out in the Hunter Valley where we've got a mission. We've got a mission today, and that mission is to get up to the Colburn Lookout up on Broken Back Range. It's looking pretty flush. It's probably the only day that we're not going to get any rain, so we're hoping to get right up on top of that mountain range there to kick on and go and see what kind of trouble we can get ourselves into. It should be an absolutely sensational day for it. The twins looking awfully shiny last week, actually had the ceramic coating done, which I'm absolutely wrapped with at this stage, full detail and clean. So the other test we're going to be doing is seeing how dirty we can get the old girl and check out what kind of clean we have to give her later on this afternoon or maybe tomorrow, whenever. Got some pretty big showers expected through the week, but today is looking absolutely stunning. Come and have a look around. This is one of the lookouts off McDonald's Road, and it is an absolutely stunning lookout indeed. Oh, look at that beautiful bike, would you? So, Colburn State Forest, just up there. We are going to head out and go and have a good look at it and see if we can get all the way up. It will start down here. We're going to come through the valley up here and put ourselves up. Now, you can't really see it because of the trees, but the rock shelf is right out there. But we'll definitely go and have a look and check all that kind of stuff out. I hope you guys are doing really, really well. It's I've been quite excited about getting out today because the weather's just brilliant. And, it's calm. There's no wind. There's no rain. I'm loving it. Loving it. So let's go and have some fun. We'll get on, wander up. There's a couple of other places I wouldn't mind trying to have a look at as well as we head out towards maybe Yellow Rock. And chances are the fact that I haven't got any food. I should try to find something that I could take up to the rock, up to the lookout to have a bite to eat. But, mate, everyone's so gourmet up here, you can't find anything decent. Anyhow, let's go. We'll get back to work. We'll jump on the twin, go for a blast, and have some fun. Let's do this. All right, legend. So we're back into it. This is a track that we've done before. Cracking views. We'll get a little bit of this on the way back. And see how it's all looking on the way through. Very nice little track indeed. Thoroughly enjoying it. So yeah, I really want to get up there and see if I can get to that lookout. Oh, I'm going to have to get up and start moving on the pedals again. I was being lazy. And still a lot of traffic on roads like this. A Thursday, I think? So there is going to be a fair bit of traffic around, private properties, businesses all doing their bit and working, and it's got to make sure that we keep an eye on it all. Yeah, this run, it's kind of irked me the last couple of months since I did it, and I really want to go and see this lookout. Now, I was supposed to get in touch with Steve from Wild Things. Steve's been up here on a Grom. That man is a legend. He takes that little monster everywhere, and he's had a couple of smaller bikes, and he'll go out moto camping. So he's one up on me already. Go out moto camping on it, and just having great fun. And he's one of the guys that also inspired me to get out here and get on the adventure bike. Make sure you go and check out his channel, Wild Stuff. I love the scenery around here. There we go. That gave you a bit of a scare, didn't it? I was expecting that. Yeah. And there's other places to go up through here as well. And it might try and get to Yellow Rock Lookout. May try and get out to Cedar Creek, maybe. But due to my fuel amount, I'm on 2 bars, but I actually still have a fair amount of confidence in that because I've got 210 k's of range, so I've got 150 effective kilometers, depending on how hard I go today. Look at that, it's pretty good, isn't it? So and the only fuel I know of is kind of Laguna, Broke and Cessnock. The only place I really want to go is Laguna because the food's outstanding. Now,
You'll see here, this is all private property, but there's public access, like the sign says here. So you got to take it real easy. Oh, I love that view. You do need to take it pretty easy. There is a fair amount of cattle floating around. So there's no need to go hacking around at a million miles an hour, because you're only going to get the roads shut. Well, I mean, they can't shut it, but they can certainly make it pretty difficult. A couple of horses just grazing up here. And like I said before, I've got a ceramic coating done on the twin. That was after... Hello, lovely. Oh, mate, how are you? And that was after seeing both Richie Vita and Motor Mogul get their bikes done. And I was quite keen to look at it. And actually got it done through, well, word of mouth, really, as well, here, because it's a fella who takes a lot of pride and passion in his work. Oh, paddies everywhere. So got a full detail, and on top of the full detail, I'm just making sure my water. Ooh, that looks like it's trying to come out. Oh, I'm gonna have to pull over. After seeing all the stuff going on, got it fully detailed and ceramic coated. I mean, I clean my bike after every off-road run, so you know it's sensible to look after it, wash it every time after you finish, and make it look pretty. Big thanks to everyone checking out the latest videos, your comments, your thumbs up, your new subscribers. You guys are legends. A couple of different things we're trying on the channel, playing around with it. It's funny, you know, I've seen all these videos recently about, oh, the YouTube algorithm and how do I get more likes. Mate, just do what you like. Do it because you enjoy it. Go and have some fun with it. I'm not really fussed about, you know, I've got a full-time job. I'm not going full-time YouTube. I'm just enjoying doing stuff like this and then sharing it. The real reason I got this is because I like to go back and look at it when I if I'm not riding anymore, or if I want to just go back and check it out. My young fella, I can show the young fella my flying and riding videos. That's going to be good fun. So, yeah, not fussed about algorithms and everything. Oh. Each of their own, right? You might have guessed by now I'm extraordinarily unfit. And with that in mind, I have gone and bought a mountain bike. A fat mountain bike. Fat mountain bike for fat fella. Fat middle-aged fella that needs to get fit. So, I've had some comments, oh, I don't like the heavy breathing. Well, I'll turn the volume off. That's gnarly. Now, that last video I did with the microphone sitting at the bottom of the jacket, that was a beautiful sound, wasn't it? Don't you love the sound of the standard exhaust on the twin? God, I do. I think it's awesome. So if I go out with Warren or Ian and Dale and the other lads, I'm going to set it up like that. I reckon, I reckon that'd be the way to go. I reckon that's the one I wanted to get up. Or is it that one? Maybe it's this one. I saw Teapot One's video about how to get a microphone and get everyone's conversations, but one, you probably don't hear everyone talking shit when they're out riding. And sometimes just the note of the bikes is more than enough. Where is it? Where is it? It's up here somewhere. Alright, cautious mode now. There's a track up here somewhere on the right. Ah, Well, bugger. Where is it? That must be it there. All right, and I think it's a little on the gnarly side, but let's go and give it a run. Oh, Jesus, look at that. That looks atrocious. Let's go and have a quick look. Do you like my new Hepco and Becker stand? Oh, that's still there, that's good. You got that there and you got that there. I'll go and have a quick look and see what it's like. Let's get rid of that for now. Because remember, I've still got to come down the bastard too. So you got this out here, which if that was a chicken track, I'd be happy to give it a run, maybe. Oh, look at her. Silly thing is, I'm feeling quite confident about getting up here and doing this. That chicken track goes up there. But then it gets pretty gnarly in here. Whew, told you I'm unfit. And I think that's the only real gnarly spot, isn't it? Might pop out up that way. Whew. Might try that. Let's go and give that a run. Sorry about the breathing. Told you I was unfit. Alright. Let's see how we go. Then you got this part up here, which looks pretty good actually. We'll go to the center. I have no idea where we are. But it's looking good. Puddle, yep, that's fine, we can deal with that. Fuck, seeing things. There you go. Yep. I hope I've made it. I remember it being a fair distance when I came out with the wife, when we came out in the Prado a few years back. I'm already seeing some outstanding views. All right, so there's one campsite. Holy crap, look at the water. Man, that looks gnarly as. Guys are certainly giving it a good run to get through here. And it's actually been compacted down pretty well. Look at that. Look at these views, guys. Oh, lads, we're here. Look, and we've got it to ourselves. We've done it. We've done it! Woohoo! Little successes, right? Oh my God, we've done it. We're here. Holy crap. Look at this, look. For those that haven't seen this, if you Google search Pocolbin State Forest, it's so far down. Look at the big wedge tail. Yeah, that's a drone killer. Oh, how outstanding. Look, there's trails down there. Okay, so, Pocolbin State Forest, good. That's down to where we were. The lookout is just down there somewhere, down here. Out in the distance, that's the Wadigans, Mount Sugarloaf. Out through Newcastle, home is that way. There's the Barringtons all the way out through there. That's Lambs Valley, up through there. So we've been up through there, out towards Singleton. There's those towers we went to in the last video. Not gonna go there today, been there, done that. All right, I'm stoked. And if I fall on my ass, I got my EPIRB. Woo! Oh, guys, over the moon. And look at this, the campsite. People have left some firewood, bloody legends, good work. And it's clean, look. Oh, cut the bits. We'll take some rubbish with us. And, but look. Oh, yep, we're here. All right, we're gonna chill out for a bit.
Well, legends, we made it. We're here. This is the Pocolbin Lookout, and it is an absolutely beautiful spot. We've actually got it to ourselves today. It's a Thursday afternoon. The sun is shining, as is the bike after that beautiful clean and detail, and then getting that big ceramic coat on it. This thing's going to be real easy to clean. Mind you, she's not that dirty. There's a few big puddles that we still need to go through on the way home. And we're just going to meander on our way back, but I'm really stoked that we actually made it up here. It's, I was a bit bummed in that last video, and you can actually check that video out up there somewhere and have a look at the first attempt we made on the Africa Twin. I'm slowly getting my confidence up, and I'm actually feeling a bit better about getting into some of these areas. Still haven't dropped it yet, touch wood. So yeah, I'm pretty wrapped. This is actually a day where so far everything's gone to plan. And I'm pretty happy with it. It is a great campsite, so we might go for a quick wander around and have a look around. And I'm just really relaxed. This is so good. I've actually bought some cooking gear. I'm waiting for some more things. So what we're going to do in future videos, I figure we're going to have a bit of a cook up for lunch. Sit back, relax, and then, mate, world's your oyster. This is just awesome. Anyhow, let me show you around the lookout. This is pretty cool. All right, come here. So out through here, there's the towers that we've been out to in the past. And yeah, they're pretty nifty towers, those ones. If I can just zoom in a little bit, I don't know if it's going to. Oh, of course, I've got the app on, but it still looks bloody good. They're the towers. So this is all part of the Broken Back Mountain Range, and then I will come around this way to the Hunter Valley, because the Hunter Valley is just absolutely gorgeous. Bit hazy today. The Singleton Range is actually going off a little bit at the moment, and then we can plod along here and just meander through. Oh, there we are. Get over some of these. It's a hell of a long way down. But look at that. Look at those mountains. Oh, I'm just so stoked we got up here, guys. I'm so wrapped. So this has been bloody sensational. Look at it. So yeah, valley's looking good. It's green. We've had stacks of rain. And as you've seen on the way through, there's some big puddles for us to kind of navigate as we head back on the way through. But what I'll do here, come and show you this. How nice is it? So one way in, one way out, and I'm pretty sure you can also get through here by from Broke, from out that way. Campsite, firewood, lots of open areas. Just don't fall off the cliff if you need to go to the loo. But it's just magic. Not a lot of wildlife around here because it does get pretty busy. Haven't seen any on the way up, so yeah, so pretty happy with the way that's gone. You know, pack it all up now. It's time to rock on. Got a bit of biltong because I won't be eating, unfortunately I won't be eating in the Hunter Valley anymore, and it's kind of one of the reasons why I was thinking we might get stuck into some cooking and cut the bits and pieces like that, because it's getting a bit expensive. I mean, I love my pub food, and I'll always sit back at a pub and have a good feed, but getting a bit pricey, so I figure, you know, we'll buy some gear, which I've got some cookers and that. Just got a couple more things I'm waiting for in the mail, and we'll come out here at a place like this and just enjoy it. It's pretty cool, hey? Yeah, love it. All right. I've relaxed enough. I'm getting ready. I'm psyching myself up for that run home because it's going to be a bit filthy. So why don't we go get stuck into that? I'll have a, I'll pack it all up. I'm actually glad I've taken the liners out of the Kamini jacket because it was getting a little bit toasty there for a little while. And I was glad I took it out. It's probably about 25 degrees up here with a light wind. It is absolutely beautiful. So we'll kick on and go and get messy. All right. Looking forward to this part. It's going to be good.
Well, in the time that we've been here, it's cleared up quite nicely. You can nearly see out to the ocean. I know the Insta won't really pick that up, and mountains can't. We had about a meter of snow out there last week. All right, so all the bugs and everything are starting to get hungry, so it's time to get out of here. We'll jump on the big girl, go and have a little bit of fun. We'll start this up and we'll get... Surprised that's actually survived, to be honest. Alright. So we're in my user mode. Turn the G on. Cool. It's saying I've got 195Ks. We're going to get some fuel on the way home. And go and have some fun with that. Looking forward to that. Indeed. Okay. Lovely. We will come back out here again. But for now, something just rubbed my leg. Hang on a minute. What have I forgotten? Nothing. All right, let's get out of here. I hate that feeling, you know. Okay. Oh, we'll go this way this time. It's a beautiful part of the world, isn't it? And this is this other campsite just here. Let's see if we can just kind of maneuver through here a little bit. That's also a good one. A bit close to the edge for my liking. But it's still pretty nice. People have left stuff behind, which is a bit silly. Maybe that was for wood, I don't know. There's bloody filthy spades and crap everywhere. All right. I know you want me to go through that, but I'm not. I'm not that silly. Maneuvering, slow maneuvering, I love it. Here's this other little campsite. So you can see, you can actually have a nice little fireplace. You can actually have a few people up here if you wanted to. It's pretty good. All right, let's find our way out. Still hungry. I wasn't going to have some milk built on because if you guys don't like the sound of me breathing heavy because I'm an unfit bastard, the last thing you want to hear is me chewing on dry meat. Which way did we go here? Obviously this way. Up the rock. Problem is, I am actually quite hungry. Did I come down through here? I think I did, didn't I? Yeah. Cool. I mean, I still, even though I've got this great ceramic coating on my bike, I still hate mud. I'm never gonna like mud. Atta girl. God, I love this bike so much. Ooh, now that's where I came up. Or is it? Oh, damn, I don't know. Am I about to put myself in it? I think I am. This was the original track I was trying to avoid. Never mind, let's give it a run, shall we? Oh, no. We came up this one. Yeah, because I came up on the, in the centre. So, let's go down the edge, avoid the rut. Oh, trees, yep. Weightless rider, Mr. Tax, weightless rider. I will take the chicken track though, because there are certain limitations that I must adhere to be able to look after and sustain my $25,000 pride and joy. Nice to be able to get through here. I wonder if the GoPro's recording, because I did hit the button. Two fingers on the front, pressure on the back, except for here, all pressure on the back. Lean into it. Oh, I'm going to sit down for safety's sake. Don't hit the tree. Not a bad little chicken track, that one. Man, I'm hungry. Oh, if I have to get stuck into the built-on guys, I will apologise. Bit steep here, but not too steep. I'm kind of glad I avoided that. All right. So from here we can get down to Cedar Creek. No one coming. We've done the transmission tower, so I'm all good with that. Whew. That's been a really, really good fun kind of day. Love it. If you follow Lone Rider, if you don't, you should be. I'll put the link down below. But if you follow Lone Rider, you might have seen they had their recent August giveaway, giving away a little bit of luggage, Ranger tank bag, and the Overlander pack as well. Well, I put in for it. And guys, I won. I've won one of them, which I'm so stoked with. Absolutely wrapped. So that's going to be coming soon. You should get onto it, and if I can win one of these, you can too. Go and follow all of their social media, their YouTube page, their Instagram, their Facebook. Get on it. I've always wanted Lone Rider gear, but just thought, oh, it's a bit X-y. But buy nice, not twice. Couldn't agree more. With 700, just over $700 worth of luggage coming my way, and I needed a tank bag for this too, which I'm stoked about. I'm actually now looking at getting their soft bags, because I do want to do some more longer touring. I want to do some camping, and I want to go out and spend two or three nights away if I can. So when that gear arrives, yeah. You'll be the first to know, I promise. I am getting more and more confident on this beast of a machine, you know, and I'm whoa. You want me to go where? Are you serious? How far up? 3.5 k's. No through road. You can't get through here, so I've got to turn around. Well, let's get up here and whoa, look at that shit. Yep, no through road. I've got to spin around down here. And I'm not going to go through gates. Oh, wow, beautiful part of the world, though. Look at it. I bet you they've had some water damage up here as well. That's a padlock, so we're definitely not going down. Let's go and give that other run. Bit of a shot. Where does that go? Let's see where this goes. That's a nice gate. Oh no, that's dead end as well. This must be the lookout. Man, there's so many places. Yeah. And we're going, oh no, it's going down now. Let's see where this goes. Oh, look at that view. That's beautiful. And that's where we were, up there. Now, I've been up here before. I think this is where I started playing around with the drone one of the first times. Camping out. Hello. How you doing? It's a dodgy looking character there, wasn't it? I think I've been down here on the GS. It was one of the first trips I did out in the GS when it came out. Let's see how far down we can go. Whoa! Where the hell does that go? Oh, that's saying I can go through. Balance, balance, feet, balance. Well, I wonder what's down here. There's a jump. It was easier to go over than around. Look at all this. Dude. Where are we? Dude, this is just getting worse. Ah, people dumping their crap. Whoop. What's happening down here? Oh yeah, just ruts. Standard ruts. Dab, dab. We've got to come down the mountain. It was a pretty big mountain, so you're going to have this kind of stuff, aren't you? Whew. I'm going to bring that visor down and see why people wear goggles. I think this is all property belonging to the guys that own Ivanhoe's. Ooh. If I'm going down, I'm going to have to be able to come up, yeah? Yep. This is a gnarly trail. I've got Brett Tax in my head. Weightless rider. Ooh, a road. Look at that. Do you know how much relief I'm feeling right now that we don't have to go back up that? Well, at this stage anyway. That was silly. But it was fun. Okay, haven't got the watch on today, so I don't know what my heart rate is. That was fun though. Right. Well guys, that was a hell of a lot of fun. Thank you so much for joining me. Massive success, we got up there. We got to where we wanted to be, which I'm absolutely stoked with. So I think now might just meander back, see where it takes us. All right, so goodbye Hunter Valley. That's where we were, right up there, right up the top. See, just up that way there, right there. That was pretty awesome. That was a wicked day. I'm going to head back. We'll see what happens on the way home. But thank you so much for coming along. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and the notification bell. Guys, thank you again for joining me. I hope you guys ride safe, be well, and stick around. There's a lot more coming up. Thanks again. Uru for now.